Hi, in this video I'll be looking at the lens options for the Sony PXW FX9 as well as its very advanced autofocus system. The FX9 features a locking version of Sony's popular E-mount lens mount. When attaching or removing a lens or adapter, the camera should first be turned off. To attach a lens to the locking E-mount, first ensure that the locking mount safety catch is set to the open position and the locking ring turned fully clockwise. The white dot on the locking ring should line up with the white dot on the camera body. Then insert the lens or mounting adapter so that the white dot on the lens or adapter lines up with the other two white dots. Then gently turn the locking ring counterclockwise. You should hear a small click as the locking ring safety catch engages, and you don't need to use a large amount of force to fully secure a lens. To remove a lens or adapter, first release the safety catch by pushing it upwards. Now turn the locking ring clockwise while supporting the lens until the three white dots line up, and now simply withdraw the lens straight out of the camera. Due to the very short flange back distance of the E-mount system, you can use a wide range of lens mount adapters to fit many different kinds of third-party lenses to the FX9. This makes the FX9 highly versatile, as via adapters you can use PL mount lenses designed for high-end film production, or low-cost DSLR lenses, including many older lenses for when you want a vintage look. However, it should be remembered that the FX9 is a very advanced video camera with a highly sophisticated autofocus system, as well as other options that make use of lens metadata. To get the very best from these functions, you'll want to use a Sony E-mount lens. Sony now have a huge range of E-mount lenses, from budget-friendly but surprisingly good lenses, such as the 50mm f1.8 FE, all the way up to very high quality premium lenses, such as those in the G-Master range. When choosing lenses for the FX9, it should be remembered that the sensor is a full frame sensor, and to make use of this, you'll need full frame lenses. You can also use lenses designed for APS-C or Super 35mm when the camera is set to any of its Super 35mm scan modes, but these lenses will not be usable in the full frame scan modes. The FX9 has an advanced, highly sophisticated autofocus or AF system, purpose designed for video applications. This autofocus system is called Fast Hybrid AF. It combines phase detection AF for fast, accurate subject tracking with contrast AF for exceptional focus accuracy. The speed and responsiveness of the AF system can be tailored to suit different shooting scenarios. It also has the ability to recognize and track individual faces. When fitted with a suitable autofocus capable E-mount lens, the camera can be set to autofocus using the focus auto manual switch. And in addition, the focus push auto button can be used to momentarily engage the autofocus system. Otherwise, the camera can be focused manually. In order for the camera's autofocus functions to operate correctly, if the lens has an AF-MF switch, it must be set to AF. If using a lens with a focus ring that slides between AF and MF, it must be in the AF or auto position. Some Sony lenses have a focus hold button on the lens itself. When AF is enabled and this button is pressed, the autofocus function is temporarily halted until the button is released. It's also possible to assign different functions to the focus hold button by going to the menu and project, assignable button, focus hold button. The focus detection area of the autofocus system can be altered by going to the menu and shooting, focus, focus area. By default, both the focus switch and the AF push auto button will use the same focus area, but it's also possible to set one type of focus area for the focus switch and an alternate focus area to the push AF button by going to menu, shooting, focus, push AF mode, and select single shot AF. And now you can select a different focus area for the AF push auto button by going to menu, shooting, focus, focus area AFS. There are three different focus areas to choose from. When using face detection or face priority, these modes will only function within the selected focus area. Wide covers almost the entire sensor. Zone, this is a smaller area that can be moved around the image using the thumbstick, on the hand grip, or the up, down, left, right menu buttons. Flexible spot, this is a much smaller area, useful for isolating a single object or very small part of the image. The flexible spot can also be moved around the image using the thumbstick or the up, down, left, right menu buttons. You can use the AF transition speed setting in the menu, under shooting, focus, AF transition speed, to adjust how quickly the focus adjusts. When set to 7 or fast, the focus will move very quickly from one focus distance to another. This may be useful for following fast-moving objects and action. When set to 1 or slow, the focus will change from one distance to another very slowly. This may be more appropriate for drama. My experience is that if the focus is set to a very fast transition speed, the focus can sometimes look unnatural as the focus flicks quickly from one object or subject to another. For more natural looking focus, I recommend using a slightly slower setting than default, perhaps 3. The AF subject shift sensitivity setting allows you to adjust how strongly the AF will hold onto the object it's focused on before releasing and focusing on another object. This is under menu, shooting, focus, AF subject shift sensitivity. When set to 5 or responsive, if a new significant object comes into the shot, the AF will respond quickly and move the focus to the new object. When set to 1 or locked on, the AF will remain focused on the original object, even if an object temporarily enters or crosses through the scene. The FX9's autofocus system is able to recognize faces, and it can be set to prioritize faces over other objects within a scene. In addition, the camera has the ability to differentiate between different faces, allowing you to select, memorize and then prioritize an individual face out of a group. To enable these options, go to Menu, Shooting, Focus Options, Face Detection AF, or you can use Direct Menu to change the settings. When set to off, the autofocus system will focus on whatever object appears to be the main object in the shot, whether that's a face or something else. When set to face priority, the AF operates as normal, but as soon as the camera sees a face within the shot, the camera will automatically focus on the face. In the viewfinder, a box will be displayed around any detected faces, and an orange cursor will appear under one of the boxes. The orange cursor can be moved between faces using the thumbstick on the hand grip or the menu up, down, left, right buttons. By placing the cursor under a preferred face and pressing the thumbstick or the select button, the box around that face will become a double white box, and the camera will register that face in its memory and prioritize it. Even if that face now passes out of the shot, once the face re-enters the shot, the AF will once again recognize it and prioritize it. To clear the selected face, simply move the orange cursor back to the selected face and select it again, and this will cancel the selection. When the AF is set to face only AF, the camera will only alter the focus when the camera detects a face within the shot. When there is no face, the focus distance will remain fixed until another face is detected. If an individual face has been selected, then the AF will only operate when this face is detected. And note that if you've selected face only AF and then turn the camera off, the focus will revert to face priority AF. Faces must be looking straight at the camera for the best results. Beards, facial hair and spectacles may prevent the detection of a face. When shooting with a very shallow depth of field, faces in the out of focus areas may be too blurred to be recognized. While the AF system does work even at very low light levels, the best performance will only be obtained where there is sufficient light for a good exposure. When using the Cine EI mode, the autofocus operation is best when you use a monitor LUT. You should note though that the autofocus doesn't function when using the S and Q mode. Thank you for watching.